ಇಂದ ಸಂತ ಅವರೇನೇನಿ ರೈತ ಬಜಾರ್
ಮಿಲ್ಕೆ
ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಥರ್ಮೋಸೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್
ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ 3 ಟೈಪ್ಸ್
ಅಪ್ ಡೌನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್
I am not inferior to anyone.
We are Claras. We are top on the Everest. Congratulations.
I want to be a leader.
Good afternoon, friends. I am Vasavi, PGT Social Studies from R.K. Puram. Our beloved secretary, Dr. R.S. Praveen Kumar Garu, introduced a beautiful and marvelous program to get how to get 10 out of 10 in the public examinations, and also our academic DS, Geeta Lakshmi Garu, also encouraging this program. Today, Madam, Mrs. Sridevi Garu with us for social studies. She'll share her feelings, her experiences regarding question paper and important questions with us. Ma'am is going to give important information on question paper and ask how to ask the questions in the paper, in the public examination. So, friends, all of you take down the notes.
Good afternoon, one and all. I am Sridevi here to tell the students how they have to score 10 out of 10 in their public examination. As it has become a crucial time where they have to spend a lot of time on their examination. And we have paper 1 and paper 2 in social studies. As everyone know that social paper 1 deals with your geography and your economics, and coming to your paper 2, as we know that we have your civics and your history. So we have some important topics where we have to concentrate on paper 1 and paper 2. Whereas coming to chapter 1 really features in that Himalayas, influence of Himalayas on Indian agriculture and the peninsula plateau, where we have to concentrate much on those topics. There is a chance of getting a question from that particular chapter, and basically from the first chapter we can get more marks on map pointing, wherein Indian map, political map, and your the where basically they show ranges, mountains, coast. We have to be very specific in pointing out, and because that is one of our academic standards, mapping skills. So first chapter we need to concentrate on the one of the question which is related to Himalayas and influence of Indian agriculture. And coming to the other question, what we can expect is your map pointing from the first chapter. Coming to your second chapter, ideas of development, wherein there we have to more concentrate on the case studies which are given in the textbook. Okay, whose development? The Kundakolam nuclear project. Okay, and that is related to Tamil Nadu, Tiruvanelli, and that is very important. The case study which is already given in the textbook. So, you leave that particular topic. You need to concentrate on that, and that Himachali women, how the women education is given important. And these days, we need to more concentrate on the women education, women empowerment, wherein that is basically shown in that. That women education is given prior importance in Himachal Pradesh compared to all other states in Himachali, as it is in the high altitude area, but still people are giving more importance to the education, that we have to appreciate the women over there. So that particular question we can expect that question from the second chapter. And also the abbreviations which are given in the second chapter, we need to concentrate, and you have to highlight in that. Whenever you are reading the textbook, you highlight in that the abbreviation, that HDI and per capita income, IMR, literacy rate. So these are all the things which we may get it in objective also. Okay, we should not lose even a single point. So So to score 10 by 10, textbook reference is must and must. I always say that you have to highlight, and important thing you have to highlight with the marker wherein you can concentrate. In the last revision time, we can, once we see also, it will enter into our brains. Coming to your third chapter, production and employment, that is also very important, wherein we have to concentrate on the organized and unorganized sector. We may get a question on the differences between organized and unorganized sector, which is very important. We cannot lose that. So that importance, the differences are very important, because as these days, how education is playing important role in our lives, and also the differences, we should be aware of the organized and unorganized sector. And coming to page number 34, we have a pie chart. You have to concentrate on pie chart. Why? Because we have in information skill another standard, academic standard. In the information skill, we have to concentrate on the pie chart. From the pie chart, they may ask us to write a paragraph. So if we have to interpret, we have to have the complete information. So almost the information will be given to us. By that, we have to give the opinion. That is very important. As a student, we have to be aware about what is the pie chart is given, what are the sectors are divided in it, and how we have to write it in a paragraph form. That is very important. And coming to your the fourth chapter, yes.
Can you explain us about information skill questions?
Yeah.
They are asked directly or indirectly?
Yeah, basically we'll get four questions on information skills. After the information, four questions will be given in it. Two will be direct from the information given to us. The remaining two will be indirect. I mean, it will be related, but not exactly from the chart, or that we cannot directly see and write. With the first two questions will be directly, what is the percentage, or what is the literacy rate, or what is the change, in which state it is like that. Like that questions we may get it. But coming to your the third and fourth question, it will be indirect. So luckily, it may be third question also will be direct. We cannot say, but we have to be prepared in our mind that students, two will be direct and two will be indirect. Indirect question, but related to that concept, we have to write by our own regarding that particular information given to us. So that is
so
very important.
Can you explain how the students analyze the table or given pie chart, ma'am?
Student have to look into the chart. Pie chart or table given, they have to first analyze what is the information given to us. Okay, they can put it. They can put it in what your structural form also. Like whatever the information they get, they can put in structure form and divide it. Let us suppose they have given sectors, right? Primary, secondary, and tertiary sector are given letters. Then they can put it, economy is divided into sectors. They can put a round and put a right sectors. And sectors will be divided into three, primary, secondary, and tertiary. Like that, if they write it, then automatically the examiner or the will have a clear picture that the student is able to express his opinion. What he has understand, we can see it, and then obviously we can get a clear idea about that information. So we have to use more of structural diagrams, like kind of we say, you know, the tree diagram, like that. Usually we call it tree diagram. Tree diagram also is very useful. And points, better any answer when you put it in points, that it's very, very attractive. If you write in paragraph, and we may not, when we see that, when you put it in points, no, automatically student will have a clarity, and also the examiner also will be very easy. And we need not write lengthy answer, because we have only 4 marks for that. Section 1 is, we know that 1 mark, section 2, 2 marks, and section 3 considered with your 4 marks. So in that 4 mark, when you write it in point way, that way the student may score good marks, and he may not lose the marks in it. So that's my opinion. Whenever you present answer, you have to write it in points. And coming to your fourth chapter, climate of India, global warming and all, rivers, mapping skills, okay, and Indian Peninsula, and equitable use of the water, okay, and where we have Adarsha Gramam, it is Yojana, it is given, that we have to concentrate on that. And coming to your other paper two, we have many chapters in paper one. In sixth chapter also, census, about census, when they conduct. Okay, it may come as objective or any particular answer, okay, changing that, and literacy rate, okay, and that again we may get again information skills also, they may ask on that, but sixth chapter. And seventh chapter related
what
to
what are the important questions in that chapter, ma'am?
In which chapter? Sixth.
The people. Sixth chapter.
They may ask what is the population change? Okay, what is the change in population and literacy rate? Okay, what was the literacy rate earlier and what is the present literacy? And which is the state it has high literacy rate? Kerala, like that. These questions will be come in objective as well as in the this particular thing.
Gender discrimination also.
Discrimination also they may ask. That's very important. Okay, because these days gender discrimination has been earlier with it, but slowly it is improving. That also we have to mention. Earlier it was like this. Now these days it is lot of change we can find. There is no gender discrimination. Gender bias in some states it is like that, and now it is improved and so. So we can mention the states where it is there, like that also they may score good marks.
They may ask the contemporary questions.
Yeah, contemporary questions they may ask. Many contemporary questions they may ask related to the subject also. And some outside questions also they may ask. Okay. And coming to your people and settlements also very important chapter. Okay, why Delhi is being so polluted. Okay, why many people are going and settling there. And also Hyderabad is becoming also very crowded place. Okay, pollution is increasing day by day. Rural slums are there, urban slums are there. Urban slums are increasing. And what are the facilities? They may ask in a contemporary question. Okay, what are the difficulties of the urban slums? In that way, they have to mention everything. Electricity problem, drainage facility problem. They don't have proper drainage and mosquitoes. These all, okay, the slum area. What are the problems faced by the people living in urban slums?
Urbanization problems.
Urban slums. Okay, we have both, but urban slums are facing many problems. They are not getting a proper, it is not at all organized. So that question is a contemporary question we are facing while we are crossing and we are traveling from one place to other. We will be seeing so many problems faced by the people that we can easily mention and write. Okay, and then
the Aerotropolis also.
Yeah, yes, Aerotropolis, that is also important. We may get an objective where the airports are located. That we may get objective also. What are the international airport? Where are these located? And coming to the paper two also very important. 13th chapter, League of Nations treaty of and all, and world wars. Okay, causes. Okay, slogans. And I would like to give slogan, pamphlet, and a poster. That's very very important. Where it's a very easy where a student should not miss a marks over there. I feel they need to concentrate. Slogans are very important. Okay, conservation, environment, water. Okay, world peace. Okay, these are all the questions where they may ask a slogan. So slogans are very easy. It should be a catchy sentence or a phrase. Always slogan is should be a catchy phrase or a sentence. And we know many save water, save life. Okay, conserve. Conserve water, conserve life. Okay, this is very important slogans are there. They have to keep a separate book or a paper wherein they have to write all the slogans. They have to write the topic and write the slogans. Related slogans all they have to prepare, because in which angle they'll ask, we don't know. So we have to be prepared with all the slogan. And poster making also very important. Poster in then wherein we have to show some picture in it. Yes. Okay. And also some bullet points should be shown in it. Okay, whereas only a pamphlet is a thing where
the poster, the caption is first, I think.
Yeah, caption is the first. First the caption and then the picture and then whatever the bullet points we can write. So, but poster should be with the picture. First is a caption and then the picture and then we have to show that. And only the pamphlet where the children will lose marks,
yes.
Okay, that they have to concentrate. Because it's a printed material. Printed material, first they have to write the reasons. Okay, we can write the first reasons within 3 to 4 sentences, and then they have to write their opinion or kind of conclusion. That becomes a pamphlet. Therein we can just write a caption or points also we can mention there. So pamphlet is only a little thing where they have to concentrate, because poster with their own drawing skills they are doing it. Okay, I've been seeing slogans all that they are able to write. Only pamphlet they are losing marks. So they need to concentrate on the pamphlet. So these are three things. And apart from this, we have a letter writing also.
Ma'am, will you give one example pamphlet?
Yeah, pamphlet like migration, let us suppose. Migration. So we can write the heading as migration. In that reasons, we have to write why people are migrating. Why people are migrating? Because they don't have proper irrigation facilities, or if they are depending on agriculture, let us suppose. the agriculture, they should have water facility, irrigation facility. That is not there. They cannot do their cropping properly. Then they are shifting to urban areas. Okay, in urban area, there's nothing organized. They don't have their identity over there. Okay, people migrating. So these are the problems. Okay, migration, they be relating to migration, they have to write 2 to 3 points, and then they have to write their opinion. In that case, government provides some kind of measures for the agriculture. If they're providing some measures for the agriculture, irrigation facilities are provided, people will not migrate. They will happily live in their own villages, in their rural area. Happily, they do their own work. They need not go to other places, right? So that way, they have to write the opinion. First as the reasons and then the opinion. That becomes a pamphlet. That way it is easily they can write. So first reasons and then opinion. Opinion or conclusion we can say.
Okay, ma'am, is it in a paragraph wise or bulletin points?
Point wise will be better. Basically they write in paragraph, but if you write in point wise, there is a scope of scoring marks.
Okay.
We have to write in points only. It will be very catchy for the points.
Examiners.
When we read a point, yes. We can easily examine, and we can know the idea of the student, what he want to produce on the paper. Presentation we can easily analyze. That way it is very good. And coming to the, what you say, reflection and this thing. People, when you give a paragraph, they have just...
Yes, ma'am. I am also observed that.
They just write the same paragraph and give it to us.
Mm-hmm.
So that way we have to concentrate in that reflection and understanding and reflection. They have to read the paragraph properly and make that into 4 paragraphs. In that 4 paragraphs also you can use points. I'm not saying you have to write exactly sentences form, that you have to divide the answer in 4 way in such a way that in the first part we have to write the introduction. Okay, what is the topic given to us? Okay, in that introduction, we have to write the sectors, it could be a migration, whatever, in introduction. Coming to your second this thing, we have to write the what are the reasons of what. And coming to your third this thing, measures. And coming to your 4th paragraph, we have to write the opinion. That we have to concentrate and we have to tell the students about it. The 4 paragraphs, we have to give importance on understanding and reflection.
Ma'am, I'm having a last year paper.
Okay.
Will you explain it?
Yeah.
Read the paragraph and comment on it. Question.
Okay. Here, this read the following paragraph, write your opinion on it. Today, this is a major source of water for people. When there is so much of extraction, it affects others in connected areas. It affects the stock of water that would be available for future generation. Therefore, one can't allow individual landowners to extract as much water as they wish for their land. There should be some restrictions. These restrictions will be acceptable if we first dealing the connection between ownership of land and water drawn from the underground system through tube wells on the land. This is the paragraph given. Here when we read this, we can understand that here they're talking about the table groundwater of the problem. If we go on dig and we go for the bore wells, it will affect the other areas. Okay. So here in the first paragraph, we have to tell about the what is the major problem here, what we are facing. Okay, water resources. Water resources play a very important role. Where in agriculture? For agriculture, we need water resources. Water resources, whenever the rains come, we have to, that sustainability we have to maintain. Okay, right? We have to grow more of trees. Okay, more of grass. Okay, when rain comes also that water will be absorbed. Okay, in that first paragraph we have to tell about the how the rainwater can be preserved and it can maintain for the next coming year. In coming to your second paragraph, we have to tell about how, what are the measures to be taken. Okay, what as an individual or what the government should take the measures and then the causes and then measures. And then lastly, we have to write the opinion. Okay, it's all about the, and if government take any strict action, then automatically it can be controlled. Okay, recently we have seen the demonetization, this thing. Okay, once a rule has come, then automatically everything will be come into its control. Like that, if any government takes any measures relating to this conservation of the water table water, then that would be very good. So like that, in the 4 paragraphs, we have to divide. And what basically happens to the student, they don't understand from the other areas I'm talking about. So they'll just copy the same paragraph and give it to us. So this paragraph to be should be understood, and they should give their opinion in the fourth paragraph.
Yes,
first three should be that.
Because it has 4 marks in each paper. That's
yeah.
why it is very important.
Very, very important.
How to get 10 marks.
Yes. So that they should not lose. They have to write the what exactly that paragraph is given about. We should get our own opinion on it. Okay. Opinion, our own interest, we'll be writing in the fourth. But first one is we have to analyze what exactly the paragraph is telling us about. Coming to the second paragraph, causes. For third paragraph, measures. And fourth is our opinion. That way we have to write. That way they will not lose the marks. And here it is given one question. Categorize the drainage system based on its origin. So drainage system means they'll think about some other. I've seen some of the students have written open drainage and underground drainage. That is absolutely a wrong answer. We have to tell about the river water, the Himalayas, where it is coming from. That is the drainage system.
Yes.
Okay. Once they hear to the word drainage, they'll think about the other way of. So here we have to be very clear enough. Okay, and mention the factors of production. It's very easy. Land, labor, capital, organization. They have to mention, and according to their land, they have to explain what is land, labor, capital, because it's an important 4 marks answer. So they have to elaborately and write. That also they have to write it in points. If you say land, the natural resources present on land. Okay, what all comes with on the land. Okay, all that point they have to write in land. Labor, physical labor, mental labor. Okay, there are 2 types of labor. Okay. That physical labor who work, put the physical efforts on it, mental labor who intellectually work, okay, then that labor, okay, how in that, again we can mix little bit of organized sector, unorganized sector, labor, okay, when people working in organized sector, what are the benefits, little bit of that information you can just insert in it, almost because it comes under the labor, this thing. And coming to the capital, so capital means we know, for any particular this thing, without capital we cannot do. Okay, money plays a very important role. Money is what money does. So these all things have to come under capital. Coming
working
to organize,
capital and
working capital,
capital,
physical capital, we have to mention. Okay, capital plays a very fixed capital, working capital. Okay, all the capital what is used on in the production process. And then coming to your service sector. So service sector related to your trade, transport. Okay, banking, insurance, services all comes under your the service sector. So this all we have to mention. Automatically when you write on each particular concept, each factor, we will get almost 2, 3 points. You'll get a big paragraph for that. So automatically there is a scope of scoring good marks. And coming to your outline map of Telangana, they have to learn an outline map of India. Okay, and in the paper 2 also they have to concentrate on the world map and other maps where they have to concentrate.
Is there any possibility to ask the political map also, ma'am?
Yeah, there is scope. Better because Telangana with 31 new districts, okay, if they are aware of it, there is no scope of losing marks. Okay, better once they check into it, that will be better. And coming to the time management, ma'am, always time is very, very precious. Okay, right? 2 hours, 45 minutes. Basically here 15 minutes are given for reading. They have to concentrate on the reading. Basically what happens with the student's attitude, I'll tell you. Once they see the paper, once they read first question, second question, if they are comfortable with, they feel that, okay, the questions are very easy, they'll carry on with the script. But that's very wrong. For a good student who want to get 10 out of 10, excuse me, so they have to read the question paper thoroughly. 15 minutes are basically given for the reading. Excuse me, ma'am. exclusively given for reading. Better please, students, I again tell you once again, but 15 minutes are allotted for reading. Better concentrate on reading. Then only you start the answering your paper, because that helps you a lot. Maybe if you just start with the first question and later on you stuck up with the other question, it becomes a problem. So 15 minutes exclusively given, better go through the whole question paper, and whichever you are perfect in it, you start with that and mention the section and also the question number. Question number is the must. So within hurry, what happened? They renumber the same question with the other. By that, what happens? It becomes difficult for the examiner. You have to mention the question number properly. Okay, that is very, very important. And as they should be aware about the question paper pattern, okay, the section 1 will be of 1 mark, and section 2 about the 2 marks, and section 3 about the 4, and 17th question all completely will be mapping. And coming to objective, objective should be written in the script. Okay, don't attach the objective paper to the answer script. You have to mention. And what I suggest the student is, don't write just A, B, C, and whatever the option given to you. If you write A is the answer, A you write, and in brackets, better write, if it's related, answer is fishing. A, and then write fishing. B, it is, which is related to some other year, 1967 or whatever. Write the, in bracket, you write the answer also. That would be very, very convenient. So that way, there is no scope, because overwriting will be will be done by all the students. So by overwriting, whether it is C or whether it is D or whether A or B, it is really a confusion. If you write the answer, correct answer in the bracket, that gives you clarity. In case that objective A or B it is overwritten, also the answer will be written in the bracket. So that way also you will not lose the mark. So better keep it in mind, students. Always mention the objective in the answer script booklet, and at the same time you mention the section A, B or whatever it is, whatever the answer it could be, and in brackets mention the answer. They have to write the answer. Only one bit they have to write. So that will not consume much of time, I feel. So better do keep it in mind that.
For objective, the elimination process is...
Yeah, that is very good question. Elimination method is very good. Let us suppose the following is not included in tertiary sector, or following is not included in primary sector. Like that they may ask. That way we can do with the elimination method. If first one is not related to that, okay, we can put it in mind. Yeah, this is wrong. Go for the second option, then go for the third option. So whichever you find it correct answer, then automatically when you eliminate, one will be there which it will be in a dilemma whether it goes or not. That way you will not lose mark. If you know the correct bit, automatically you put a correct A or B, C or D option, that's well and good. But when you are confusion with that particular objective type bit, in that case, they have to go with the elimination method. That way, a student will never lose even half mark. So, elimination method is the very best method in objective type.
Is there any chance to ask questions on appreciation on persons or environment like that?
Yeah, there is a chance. They may ask on the environment, because social studies is related to environment, so they may ask on, and they may ask the contemporary issues also. We have to keep it in mind, the recent one where the agitation is going on for this Jallikattu movement, okay, yes. In which state it is going on, they may ask an objective. They may not ask in detail, but they may ask the objective type, in which state it is, or the Jallikattu is related to where it is going on, where the agitation is going on. They may ask like that, a simple. And the ministries, okay, who is our education minister, or who is our irrigation minister, okay, who is our finance minister. This kind of, if the student is aware with the current affairs and little bit of news and all, okay, that will be good. Because only textbook means there is a chance textbook maximum they'll cover. 99.99% they'll cover the textbook. But there is a one point also we should not miss. We are talking about 10 by 10. So in that particular situation, this contemporary issue or the news, what it is coming on, that also the student should be aware of it. In that way, there is a scope. We'll not even lose half mark. That is my opinion. So they have to use with the, have the information about the news also, little bit of. Then they will not lose half mark.
Okay, in first paper, sustainable development and food security.
Yes, ma'am.
Both are important for appreciation and sensitivity questions.
Yes, ma'am, there is a chance. Appreciation and sensitivity, these two questions, sustainability and food security, because food security is very, very important, because that is related to what midday meals. Now in schools and all, midday meals program is going on. Okay, when food security is there only, these all programs what we are government implementing, this we can be done, right? So food security, and that is again related to agriculture, okay? And water resources, all topics are each and everything interconnected. So once topic you are prepared with, then whichever angle they ask you the question, you can put it on the paper presentation. But when you're presenting, I tell the students, you go with the structural diagrams. Okay. Structural diagram, like a tree diagram. Put it in some circle and put some arrows in it, and put that whatever comes under that. Like that, if you put, then automatically you can easily frame the points on each and every point. That way, the answer presentation looks good, and like when the examiner is correcting, okay, student is aware of this particular topic. Like that, the examiner gets an opinion on the student. So structural and points are must. Points are the must. No paragraph writing. Paragraph lengthy. We may also lose some points in it. If you write in points, we may not. When you're reading also, when you're preparing also, better learn the answer in point wise. That is very beneficial for the student. And the abbreviations what are given in the textbook also very, very important. Better don't leave any abbreviation, because in that abbreviation it may they may ask the IMR stands for in objective. They may ask like one mark questions are there. They may ask that. Okay. What are the things come under primary sector? Okay, what is primary sector? Okay, what are intermediary goods? Okay, that way one mark questions will be there. So you need to concentrate on each and everything. Thorough preparation of textbook is must to students. That way they will not lose even half mark. And
I think there is necessary to draw the maps also wherever necessary.
Yeah, wherever necessary regarding to like paper one related to geography. Then they have to draw the India south part of the India they can draw, and then mention there, and then write the answer. That way gives more attractiveness for the presentation. Presentation is very important. They have to concentrate on the presentation.
It is easy also.
Yeah, easy also. Yeah, students also easy, and for teachers also.
They don't forget.
They don't forget. That's answers. Very best method. Mm-hmm.
And what are the important chapters in second paper, ma'am?
Second paper. We have 13th chapter, 14th, 15th, I'll tell you. 13th chapter, World Wars, okay, the treaty and Great Depression, okay, and slogans, prevention of wars, promoting peace. On that, they may ask slogans in it.
Okay.
And chapter 14 also Russian Revolution, okay, picture reading, page number 205, map reading, and page number 202, okay, and the map reading is very important. Okay, compare the national movement in India and Nigeria, oil, environment, and politics. Here in contemporary issue they may ask, okay, establishing new democracy, okay, system. And chapter 15 also reason for again supporting British in World War II, okay, Muslim League, RSS, popular, 1946-48, okay, assassination of Mahatma Gandhi. You may expect one question on that. Okay, they have to write that also they can write in points when happened. Okay, that all in detail they can write in a point, assassination of Mahatma Gandhi. That's very important.
They may ask the appreciation skills also.
Yeah, yeah.
Subhash Chandra Bose.
Yes, they
Mahatma
may.
Mahatma Gandhi.
Yeah, they
Vallabhai Patel.
Yeah, sure, ma'am. There is a scope. There's a scope to ask that. And chapter 17, making of Indian Constitution, federalism, unitary government, differences, okay, principles of constitution, preamble, okay, poster and slogans, okay, that is very important. And tributaries also they may ask, okay. And if you don't know any particular answer, let us suppose, don't leave the space. Students have very bad habit. They'll think, okay, later I'll write, and they'll leave the space. And by that, what happens when the time won't be sufficient, the empty space will be left over like that. That way, the impression of the student will go wrong. So never leave the space in between. If you're perfect with the answer, then only you take up that particular answer. What they feel, they'll first attempt. Then later on they'll write 3 point, 4 point, then leave some 5, 6 points and then go for the other question. By that, the examiner will get a bad impression on that particular presentation. And if you know with the years and dates, then only you mention and then underline. If you're not perfect with the dates and years, better don't mention. And history and all, better don't mention that. Okay? And you should have a little bit of idea about the current affairs. I already told you. Abbreviation forms, they have to keep it in mind. Okay? Important lines, years, names should be highlighted in the textbook when you're preparing. Important lines and the years. Okay? And in second paper, Europe, Africa, maps, they have to consider South America, map pointing. They may ask. Not only world map, they may ask Europe, Africa also. There is a scope of asking. Okay? And symbols in mapping point, symbols and project mountains and all. Okay? They have to mention. Rivers also they have to mention. Mountains also they have to mention. Everywhere mapping, you have to use pencil only. Better use a dark pencil wherein you can mention. But if you use a dark pencil, first you do it lightly. If you're confident enough, then you make it as a dark. Okay? And coming to the 17th bit, what the mistake done by the student, they have part A and part B, ma'am. What they do, they take 2 points from the part A and 17th question B bit. From there, they'll do the two. That's a very, very wrong method. Either you'll not get marks for that, either you'll not get the marks for this. You want a full mark, then better do A or A bit, 4 points are given, map pointing. Either go for B. If let us suppose the A and B bit, both you're perfect, then what you do, use a different pencil and one pen. That way, there is a scope, according to me. Better not, but in case, if you are confident enough, I know these 4 points and also these 4 points. Then that case, what you do, use a separate pencil for map pointing both. All the eight, you can do it on one particular map. Better don't, but in case, if you don't want to lose a half mark, because we're talking about 10 out of 10. Yes. So what happens, they'll be, if you do 2 points from 17A and again 17B2, there is a scope of losing marks. Children, better don't do that mistake. Okay, it's my suggestion. If you're perfect with 17A, A, B, C, all D, all you do. If it is 17B, then better don't do it.
Hello.
Hello, good afternoon, madam.
Good afternoon, Andy.
This is Deepka Sara from Mattampally.
Okay.
What is the difference between poster and pamphlet?
Ma'am, poster wherein we have to mention a picture. First is heading you have to write, right, regarding what is asked. Then you draw a picture and then you point out some bullet points in it. That is a poster. Picture is must. In a pamphlet, it is a brief sentences. Sentences, either points, wherein there won't be any picture in it. Okay?
Okay, madam. And another question.
Okay.
How can I get full marks about poster and pamphlet?
Yes, ma'am. For the poster, you make it in a colorful. You can go carry your, drawing pencils with you. Right? A student should carry a drawing pencils. And you make it in a rectangular box. Fine? You're getting it? Right? Rectangular box and then draw the this. Let us suppose you would like to tell about the traffic rules or crossing the road. What a student has to put it in a poster. Then what I'll do, I'll draw one small person picture over there. I'll draw a zebra crossing. Fine. I'll draw two smiley pictures left to right. Okay. And then I write look left, look right, again look left and then cross. That way I can show the poster. Whereas in a pamphlet, I'll just write that, okay, whenever you're crossing the road, you have to take into certain measures, okay, go according to the signals and all. Like that, we have to write it in a written form. Hello? Hello?
Hello, good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
I am Sarita, ma'am. I have one doubt.
Okay.
Which one we use to locate map pointing, ma'am? Pen or pencil?
Better go with the pencil, ma'am. Pencil.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Hello? Yeah.
Okay, ma'am. Will you show me one poster? Do you have one?
Yeah, poster? I'll show you.
here in this poster, like crossing the road, I've shown here a person standing here, okay, zebra crossing here, and then here look left, look right, then again look left, and then cross. This way we can show a poster.
Okay.
Okay, and here I've shown here save water, save life. Okay, each drop, each life. In each drop I've shown one kind of a, like a person figure, a small picture. Okay, each drop, each life. It's a rough diagram I've made it. Okay. Hello?
Hello?
Yes?
Good afternoon, madam.
Good afternoon, sir.
This is Vinay Kumar Sarah from Dampet.
Okay. Tell me.
Madam, can you explain how can we write comment on passage?
Comment.
Comment on?
Paragraph.
Passage.
Pamphlet. Pamphlet. Pamphlet.
Yeah, my chance,
ma'am. On pamphlet you're talking about? Pamphlet actually, sir. The information what they're asking us, that we have to write in points.
Okay, ma'am.
First we have to write the reasons and then we have to write the opinion.
Okay.
Hello?
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. So regarding 4 marks questions,
mm-hmm.
the first skill. About first skill, I think they write the introduction part also.
Yes, ma'am. Introduction is compulsory. Whenever they ask, first we have to write the introduction, then the reasons.
Okay.
Okay. Then causes and then opinion. That way we have to divide the answer.
For example, there is a question in mm-hmm. this parliamentary system. What are the differences between parliamentary system and presidential system?
Yeah.
So first they write what is parliamentary system and what is
presidential
system.
Mm.
And then
mm.
after that,
they
what
have
are differences? Differences and similarities.
Similarities.
Okay.
That becomes answer.
Okay.
Differences, similarities, and that becomes answer. And which one you would opt?
Okay.
Which one you would like? Your
opinion.
Opinion mm. you have to mention.
Okay. And the conclusion.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Then
hello.
They get
hello.
They give a pie chart and a paragraph.
Mm.
What is the difference between comment and the analyzing?
Comment and?
Analyzer.
Analyzes the thing, whatever the information they have given, on that we have to analyze and put it in a, what do you say, paragraph type. Like if let us suppose a pie chart is given into 3 sectors, primary and secondary and tertiary sector. And in the year 1992 and 92 and 2009 and 10, the information is given like that, fine. Then what you have to analyze there, the above pie chart, tell us about the 3 sectors, right? Are you getting it? Okay, 3 sectors that is divided into primary, secondary and tertiary sector, and the percentages of contribution or production, it could be, it was earlier in 1992 like that, it was like this, and later on 2009 and 10 it was like this. Why that is a change, why the shift has taken, or why the percentage has been changed, that we have to analyze. And coming to comment in the sense, when you the paragraph is given to you, what the paragraph is given to us, that we have to write the first introduction, then we have to write the causes, then we have to write the measures, and then we have to write the opinion. That is the comment. Okay. Hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
This is Pravanika Sarah from Narayan Pet School.
Okay.
Yeah, ma'am. I have one doubt about if the question is given, comment on it.
Question is given?
Comment on it.
Yeah. The same question has been repeated again.
So?
Yes.
So that time, how we have to write the answer?
Yeah.
We have to write the answer shortly or briefly by step-by-step points.
See, basically you have to divide the answer in 4 paragraphs, ma. Fine. So in the first paragraph, we have to write the introduction, what the topic is asked about, the introduction. Okay. Is that clear? Then coming to your second paragraph, you have to write the causes. Then third paragraph, measures. And 4th paragraph, opinion. So when you write this 4 paragraph also, need not, it should not be in a paragraph mode only. You can write that also in point wise. But if you write 4 points, it should be interaction. Next to 4 points should be causes. And next to 4 points should be measures. And the next to 4 points should be your opinion. Got it, dear? That's about your commenting the answer.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so very much.
Okay. Welcome. Yeah. Okay. Hello? Hello?
Hello, hi ma'am, this is Pallavi Sparrow.
Okay, tell me.
And I want to ask you one question. In opinion question, how will it conclude? How will it conclude that opinion question?
See, as we should be aware about the topic, dear. Then once you are aware about the topic, automatically if you can, let us suppose the question is asked about the migration. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
So
thank you, ma'am. My friend want to ask you another question.
Yeah.
Hi ma'am, I'm Srija Sarov.
Okay.
Studying 10th standard.
Yeah.
Ma'am, if we have 4 marks question,
mm-hmm.
should we write all the paper or just bullet points is enough?
You want paragraph or points you're asking?
If they gave 4 marks question, madam.
Yeah.
How long the answer should be?
See, how long in the sense, ma'am? I told you when you say comment on it, we have to divide the answer into four, how the major divisions. First will be introduction, okay. Second would be your causes, third would be your measures, and fourth will be your opinion. That is a major division. In the first introduction, you can write in 4 points, four introduction points you can write, right. Second also, you can write the causes into 4 points, and third also measures into 4 points, opinion into 4 points. Is that clear? Yeah. Hello.
Good
Hello.
Evening, ma'am.
Yes. Good afternoon. Tell me.
This is Rautesh Sparrow from Dhammapeta, ma'am.
Okay.
What is the differentiation between proxy war and the cold war, ma'am?
Yeah.
Proxy war and cold war. Difference.
And cold war, ma'am.
Difference between proxy war and cold war. He's asking.
We have to make it a differences table and then you have to mention it.
He's
okay.
Asking what is the difference. Okay. Ma'am, will you give any suggestions? More suggestions.
See, the general suggestion what I would like to give is, the student should go for a proper planning. Okay, it's almost nearing to the exams. So at least this day onwards, if you start your planning and divide your days into your all equal subjects, okay, and planning is must, and little focusing on the subject than other like your TV or any other this thing, you have to put it a shut to it, and then only concentrate on your subject. Now, totally, you can say that once you do a thorough preparation, we all have a stress of 10th class and all, okay? It's a hurdle. You can easily jump over it once you have a proper planning. If you don't go for a proper planning, then it becomes a problem. So, planning is must, timetable is must, okay? They should have a little bit of physical exercise, okay? At least do a little bit of meditation. I mean, if the student go for a little bit of meditation also, they can improve their memory skills and all, okay? And timetable is must, okay? And once they go with the thorough preparation, that they'll score good marks. There is no chance of losing any marks, okay? Thorough preparation should be there. Hello?
Madam, this is Deepak Sarah.
Yes?
Presidential system, parliamentary system,
hmm?
Presidential and parliamentary system. What is the best government?
What is the best government in presidential and parliamentary system?
Hmm.
Yeah, he's asking.
Hello.
Parliamentary and presidential system.
Yeah.
In both the systems, which is the best one? He's asking that question.
Oh, okay. Parliamentary is the best, but in some countries they go with the presidential rule also. But coming to systematic way, presidential would be better because we have all IAS officers and all the cadres. that will be in a different form. Okay, we have tried there our own opinion, which is the best.
Both are successful.
Both are successful. In some countries,
presidential
is successful. In some countries, parliamentary
system
is successful.
Both are successful.
Both are successful.
So democracy is...
Democracy. Hello?
Ma'am?
Yes?
What are the major topics on the part to be?
I already mentioned, Uma.
But once again, tell me what the major topics in the part to be.
In part B, I have told, chapter wise I told here already all the things chapter wise I already discussed.
Once again, can you repeat?
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am.
One second, I'll tell in a very short form method so that you can. About World War 1 and 2, causes, results, okay, changes after the war. About UNO, League of Nations, Russian Revolution, changes, fascism and Hitler, Russian during Stalin, about Great Depression, reasons for partition, salient features of Indian Constitution, one party dominance, major changes in political system after 1967 elections, Indira Gandhi left turn, emergency period and institutional changes that come up after the emergency, and telecom revolution and Rajiv Gandhi. Liberalization, okay, NAM, non-alignment movement, okay, India's relationship with neighboring countries, okay, and gentleman agreement 1969 agitation, and modes of mobilization, methods used in Telangana state formation, differences in access to water, agriculture, education, employment in the two regions. These are the important topics where they have to concentrate on paper two. Hello.
Hello, madam.
Yes.
The impact of globalization is not being uniform in our country. Why, ma'am?
Impact of globalization is not uniform.
Hello.
Yeah, yeah. Impact of globalization, it's not uniform in our country, you're saying, right?
Yes, ma'am.
It will be regulated, but in some sectors, it has been regulated. In some sectors, it has to be still to be regulated. Still, the government are taking certain measures to it. So, slowly it takes in their place. So, it takes time for the regularization. Slowly, because a new government formed, so many problems will be there. One by one after the other, they will set into their place. Hello?
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes, good afternoon.
Ma'am, can you please tell how to analyze the information skills under pie chart?
Yes, ma'am, we have to observe the pie chart thoroughly, right? And then what exactly the pie chart is given for us. Basically, when they give the pie chart, they give two pie charts or one pie chart, they give the year percentage will be mentioned clearly in the pie chart. Then what does that pie chart tell us about? That first we have to write basically what is given on it. First will be introduction. Second will be your the what are the causes related to it and what are the measures we have to write, and then the opinion. Then we have to analyze our own opinion in the last paragraph. Hello?
Hello, ma'am?
Yes?
Is there any places
in
like
mountains
like different places?
Not able to hear.
Yeah, your voice is not clear, dear.
Yes, ma'am. I'm lost now. In the chapter of India.
Not audible.
Which chapter?
Planet of India.
Okay.
So in the chapter, there is a graph.
Climate of India. There is a graph.
Climographs
are there. Based on climographs, you may get an information skill question, dear. What is the increase, okay, decrease, where is the high, why the temperature, in which months the temperature is high, okay? Related to that, they may ask this thing. So, better go through the climographs, this thing.
Okay.
And we have on a table also the different in Telugu version masas and all it is given. So Vaishakha, Chaitra, that is also given.
Yes, yes.
So that also you have to concentrate a little bit.
Why the temperatures are different?
Why
in
the
different
temperature
regions.
In different regions? They may ask an information skill. Okay, that climograph picture they may give and ask. In so months the temperature, which months the temperature is high, in which months the temperature is low, why it is low. Okay, rainfall is high in which months? Okay, like that the question may ask. That will be a direct question, and that something will be in two questions will be indirect.
Indirect.
So that we can they may ask. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
No.
Hello.
This is Simbu Swaro from Kandamalapalli, Nalgonda district.
Okay.
Question is how to interpret the given paragraph.
Yeah, the same doubt all the students have. Interpretation is nothing but we have to be clear with the paragraph given to us. Paragraph is related to what subject? Related to what subject it is given. In that interpretation, first you have to write the introduction points, dear. Okay, right? Introduction points, you have to write 4 points, not more than that. Then coming to the subject, it is given with the causes. What are the causes for it? And coming to the next four points will be your measures. And the last 4 points will be your own opinion on it. That is interpretation. What is your own idea regarding that particular subject given in the question paper or the question, whatever it's asked to you. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Hello?
Hello, ma'am. This is Raudija sir from Dhammapeta, ma'am.
Okay. Good afternoon. Tell me.
I have a doubt in page number second, ma'am.
Page number two. Okay.
Mm.
There is a question of view of Himalayas from Tibetan plateau.
Mm.
Notice the absence of trees. Why? It may come that type of questions in examination, ma'am.
Sorry.
Sorry, I can't. I'm not clear. Why is it not clear, dear? Tell me. Why?
View of Himalayas from Tibetan plateau.
Mm.
Notice the absence of trees.
Absence of?
Trees.
Why? Trees.
Mm. Yes, ma'am.
Absence of trees. Himalayan trees. Huh? I'm not getting it. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you so much, giving
for
a nice opportunity to talk to the students. And I hope all the best to all the students. And don't get scared about the CC cameras which are going to come. You're all you have put your sincere efforts throughout the year. Okay. Your teachers' support is there. You have been putting a sincere efforts so long. So don't get scared about it. Okay, even the whatever the cameras are said to you, you just don't concentrate on that. Better concentrate on your subject and have your hope on your own, this thing, your own, you should have confidence in yourself. Okay, not else what is around, you don't bother about it. You have put a lot of sincere efforts so long. So continue with that same thing. Same support will be given by your teachers and lot of confidence should be put. You should not be, discouraged. Or depressed with this all the news, but compulsory this year we will be getting a CC camera. So well, thorough preparation, continue the same way. All the best to all the students. Okay, we should get good results this year in social studies. All the best. Thank you, ma'am, for giving this opportunity.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your valuable suggestions, and I must thankful to our beloved secretary and academic DS.
Yeah, I'm also saying thanks. Thank you.